put a bunch of Peeps right in the, into the beaker and set it into the bell jar. Turn on the vacuum pump and ready. Do you think it's going to expand or contract? Let's see what it does to the Peeps.
It's like they're growing. Why does that happen? Why is it that the Peeps are growing when I put them into the bell jar? Now, what's happening is the air is getting removed. So the atmosphere is getting removed out of the environment of those Peeps. But there's air inside the Peeps. So could it be a relationship between pressure and volume? What do you think?
Okay, so they shrunk down.
So next, let's give shaving cream a try. So
let's see how much shaving cream I have left.
Shaving cream, of course, is just basically soap and gas, whether that gas is air or some other gas. So if there's a gas inside shaving cream and I remove the pressure by removing as much of the atmosphere around the shaving cream, you can see how it expands. So that gas inside is getting room now, because there's not atmospheric pressure pushing on it. It's getting room now to expand. And of course, that is relationship between pressure and volume.
So last is the balloon. And I didn't fill the balloon up completely. Let's see what happens when we put a balloon into the bell jar. You might be surprised to see. Now remember, this is completely sealed up, right? There, I can't untie and put air into that balloon. So let's see what happens when I change the atmosphere. So the atmosphere outside of the balloon is getting removed. So that atmospheric gases are getting removed. That relationship between pressure and volume of gases, I decrease the pressure, I increase the volume, so it gives more space. Gases will always pick a lower pressure environment. So in this case, it went and expanded because it had a lower pressure environment. Pretty cool.
Okay. We're in for a big surprise with this demonstration. Increasing the amount of gas inside a balloon increases the volume, which causes my balloon to... But watch what happens when I use a vacuum pump and a bell jar to remove atmospheric gases around an inflated balloon. A decrease in pressure, increase in volume. This causes my balloon to... Let's see that again and listen closely. With way less gas, you have way less sound. Why? I love this experiment. Sound waves are created when air molecules are set into motion and their energy is transmitted to adjacent air molecules. So less gas, less sound.